Good morning, everyone. Hope you're having a good morning so far. Ready to praise the Lord with me? Can I ask everyone to stand?
Give thanks to the Lord, our God and King. His love endures forever. For he is good, he is above all things. His love endures forever. Sing praise. Sing praise. With a mighty hand and an outstretched arm, love endures forever. For the life that has been reborn, his love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise, sing praise. Forever God is with us, forever and ever and ever.
From the rising to the setting sun, his love endures forever. By the love of God we will carry on. His love endures forever. Sing praise. Sing praise. Sing praise. Sing praise. Forever God is faithful. Strong. Forever God is with us, forever and ever. Forever God is faithful, forever God is strong. Forever God is with us, forever and ever.
Good morning, everyone. The watchword this morning is coming from 1 John 4, verse 21. He has given us this command: whoever loves God must also love his brother and sister. Then this morning, we want to just welcome Pastor Ron Kiesel. Ron, thank you so much for coming all this way to helping us out with this service. And we wish you God's blessing in delivering it to us. Then just a few announcements. Last Sunday, the thank offering was for the Ministry of Discipleship, and it amounted to 7,937 rand. And then today's offering is for our own contribution, and you're also welcome to do it by EFT. Then maybe just have a look at the birthdays, the upcoming birthdays this week. Then two announcements I want to just make you aware of. The first one is the Alpha course that will take place again this coming Wednesday in the CC. And then, of course, to save the date for our Village Vibe celebration, which is coming up on Friday, the 27th of October. Then also the Rincon Center has left some biscuits at the exit, just to say thank you for a donation that was made to them. So please help yourselves as you exit. There's also little thank you cards that they wrote themselves. So I think it's quite special. Thank you, guys. The psalm reading this morning is from Psalm 1, verse 1 to 6. Blessed is the one who does not walk in step with the wicked, or stand in the way that sinners take, or sit in the company of mockers, but whose delight is in the law of the Lord, and who meditates on his law day and night. That person is like a tree planted by streams of water, which yields its fruit in season, and whose leaf does not wither. Whatever they do prospers. Not so the wicked. They are like chaff that the wind blows away. Therefore the wicked will not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the assembly of the righteous. For the Lord watches over the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked leads to destruction. Let's pray. We thank you, Lord, for a new day and opportunity to gather here in your house. You indicated where two or more of us gather in your name that you will be present. Let us therefore experience you in this service, and let our worship be pleasing to your ears. Open our hearts and minds to the message that Ron will share with us, and let it resonate and bear fruit in us. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Breaks the power of sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger, the King of glory, the King above all kings, who shakes the whole earth with thundering thunder, who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder, the King of glory.
that you would take my place, that you would bear my cross, you would lay down your life, that I would be set free.
You may be seated. Can I ask the children to please come forward? Sorry, I'm wearing a mask because I've got a cold. And I don't want to make everybody sick because then you won't ever forget me. And I don't know whether that is good or bad. I'll leave that up to you. And the children, if you can stand here in a semicircle, I'll put my mask back on just now for you, okay? It's good to be here with you. I just love it here. Thank you for the invitation. Can I ask the children to hold hands? Can you do that? And pretend that I'm also holding your hand. Okay, pretend. Okay, you must also pretend. Just pretend. Lord Jesus, thank you for our children. Thank you that you love them so much that you took them in your arms and you blessed them. And we want to pray that you will just bless them now as well. Just take them in your arms. You let them feel that they are special. They belong to you. They're your children. Lord, we pray for our children's church teachers that they too may be blessed by your presence as they take the children now for children's church. God, our Father, who made us to be special, bless us. And God, through his Son Jesus, who came to just forgive us and make us new, bless us. And God, the Holy Spirit, who's with us always, bless us. God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now, I'm telling you, children, you must let them know that you were there. Otherwise, they think they've wasted time. So you're allowed to be a bit naughty, but only today. Okay, for 1 hour. Pleasure. It's nice standing here and talking.
And I'll never, ever have never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your love. In death, in life, I'm confident and covered by the power of your great love. My debt is paid, there's nothing that can separate my heart from your great love. In death, in life, I'm confident and covered by the power of your great love. My debt is paid, there's nothing that can separate my heart from your great love. Your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your love.
Amen.
So the first reading is from Ephesians 5, verse 15 to 20. Be very careful then how you live, not as unwise but wise, making the most of every opportunity, because the days are evil. Therefore do not be foolish, but understand that what the Lord's will is. Do not get drunk on wine, which leads to debauchery. Instead, be filled with the Spirit. Speak to one another with psalms, hymns, and spiritual song. Sing and make music in your heart to the Lord. Always give thanks to God the Father for everything, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. The second reading is taken from Mark 10, verse 17 to 27. As Jesus started on his way, a man ran up to him and fell to his knees before him. Good teacher, he asked, what must I do to inherit eternal life? Why do you call me good? Jesus answered. No one is good except God alone. You know the commandments. Do not murder. Do not commit adultery. Do not steal. Do not give false testimony. Do not defraud. Honor your father and mother. Teacher, he declared, all these I have kept since I was a boy. Jesus looked at him and loved him. One thing you lack, he said. Go sell everything you have and give it to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come follow me. At this, the man's face fell. He went away sad because he had great wealth. Jesus looked around and said to his disciples, how hard it is for the rich to enter the kingdom of God. The disciples were amazed by his words. But Jesus said again, children, how hard it is to enter the kingdom of God. It is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter the kingdom of God. The disciples were even more amazed and said to each other, who then can be saved? Jesus looked at them and said, with man this is impossible, but not with God. All things are possible with God. Here ends the reading.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into the realm of the dead. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the dead, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Thank you. I was expecting another song there. But that's okay. I must say, you musicians are fantastic here. Can I take you with to the Seafarers Mission? We need some good musicians there. You coming?
Yeah.
Great. I've stolen one of your people and I did it in church. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, may the love of God, and may the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all. Amen. Dear God, we thank you that you speak to us through your Spirit. We thank you that you are present here, touching each one of us. And God, you know exactly where we are at, what we are experiencing, where our needs are, where our joys are, our troubles. We bring all of that to you and we pray that we may hear you speaking to us now. And we pray that this word may bring comfort, may challenge, may do what it is meant to do in our lives. And we pray that you will also use my mouth to speak to your people. Pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Can somebody read that word? Salbona. Saubona. Does anybody know what it means? I see you. Now you can put on the next one. I see you. I think that is so amazing about that Zulu greeting, Saubona. We are actually saying to that person, I see you. You know, very often we greet each other and we say, hello, how are you? And already we somewhere else in our minds. I see you. Seems so personal. I don't know whether everybody that says Saubona actually means it, but if we would take it literally, I see you. I'm talking to you. And that brings us to the first point. God sees us. I find that amazing. That our, oh, sorry, it's before that. You must go back. You write down at the bottom. It's a third one. While you're looking at those pictures and he's finding it, it's that first point, God sees us. Still up. It's technology. Our Almighty God, the God who spoke and the world happened. One back. Mind you, you can leave it there, it's fine. The God who spoke and the world happened. The God who spoke and a universe happened, and we're still discovering how big and amazing the universe is. We can't even see it with all these modern telescopes and whatever craft they are building. We're still discovering this amazing God sees you and me because I mean something to him. He's that personal with me. This incredible Almighty God says Saubona to me many times a day. Even when I'm sleeping, he whispers over me, Saubona. I'm never alone. Always seen by my Almighty God. Why? It is because he loves us. And that too is a miracle. Yes, we can say he created us. That's why he loves us. He has to love us. Parents, do you love your children? Yes, sometimes you're upset with them. Sometimes you get angry with them. But you love them. God loves us unconditionally. And that's why he'll always see us. And maybe we should think of our God as a God who does a Saubona ministry with me all the time. This amazing God. And that leads us to the third point. This amazing God who has this Saubona ministry with me also challenges us to put into practice a Saubona ministry. And before I get to details, I want to take you on a little bit of a detour. Maybe showing you where I've experienced the Saubona ministry in other countries. So I've traveled quite extensively this year. I have to confess, anybody who wanted some training on how to walk on water, I'm a bit out of practice because I've been flying so much this year. So maybe next year we can do the walking on water practice with you again. My first stop was the Philippines, and that was in February. Now I've put on a number of pictures there. The top left hand, on your left hand, that's the hotel in which we stayed. We had an International Christian Maritime Association, organized by them, ICMA, workshop in the Philippines about the Philippines. And it was important for me to take part in this workshop because I would say about 80% of our seafarers that we experience on ships are still Filipinos. So it is good to know their culture. Now, I stayed in this fantastic, beautiful hotel. You know, the bathroom, the toilet, I had to read instructions on what to do for what because it was so fancy and electronic. My goodness, I won't go into more detail. But the Philippines, when I experienced it, has this huge contrast of this incredible wealth and poverty. Now, we see at the bottom left-hand, just a picture down the street, a lot of these markets that happen, or street vendors. And then to the right, that is a street, a normal street. I didn't bring one with potholes. They have potholes in the Philippines too. But the one at the top, if you go to your right and then one to the left, I particularly put that. They love communication, but the Philippines don't fix, they replace. So you'll have over the streets, not in the main streets where the rich people drive and what the tourists see, but in the, all the side streets, you see kind of that. They just put up a new line when your thing goes wrong. And it is like a spaghetti jungle going there and looking up at this. But communication is happening. What I found interesting about the Philippines, we think of it as a small country in Asia, but it is actually it's many islands put together. They call it, I can't even pronounce the word properly, archipelagic country. Okay, you Google it and you can pronounce it better. Over 7,000 islands. Now, say over 7,000 because whoever you ask, even if you Google it, some will say 7,600 something, some say over 7,000. But if you ask the people, they look at you as if you are from some foreign universe, high tide or low tide, because that matters how many islands there are. An incredible amount of islands, a country that is, in a way, so disjointed by all of this, but water, sea, matters to the Filipinos. And that probably explains why so many Filipinos become seafarers, because it seems to be in their blood, going from one island to the next. They make boats. And it is not recorded properly, but it is believed that the Filipinos made the first boat. I'm not going to put my head on the block for that one. I was told that. The amazing thing is in the Philippines, there are many languages. Now, we talk about South Africa being a rainbow nation. Now, there are over 700 different languages in the Philippines, cultures, and with all the different dialects. So they even find it difficult to communicate with each other. Now, the main language that is used for schooling is probably Tagalog. And most of them know at least a little bit of Tagalog, so they can communicate with each other. But it is amazing that these people have some sense of we're a country feeling with that variety. What I find again and again when meeting the Filipino seafarers, and also I saw that in the Philippines, is how humble they are. In a way, when they greet you, they have this saubona attitude towards you. I'm privileged to be allowed to see you, is the kind of attitude they have. It's absolutely amazing. We've got a lot to learn from them. Unfortunately, corruption is high, and I think the South African, as we were told there, you know, and just comparing, I think our South African politicians must go for some training lessons there on how to be corrupt. We think it's bad here, even worse there. And so many Filipinos need work, are unemployed, and many of them want to go in the seafaring industry and learn. There are so many maritime schools in the Philippines. They couldn't even tell us how many, and many of them do not offer the proper training to give the seafarers that qualification they need to get proper contracts. So sometimes they spend 2-3 years and money or savings from the family to study, and then they can't get contracts for the shipping agents because they didn't do the right training. It's sad. But those who do have contracts, those that we meet in our ports, are relatively privileged because in the Philippines, they earn in dollars. So in the Philippines, they are seen to be the upper end of the middle class people. So their families live good lives. But imagine a life where you're away from home at least 9 months of the year and then go home for a month, two, to take your next contract so that the family can keep this status in the Philippines as pressure on them. And many of the Filipino seafarers are actually quite lonely because of that. I often hear them saying, I'm just like a money machine. Everybody wants. My next stop was in Antwerp. That's the next slide. Yep. We went for the German Seafarers Mission, Deutsche Seemannsmissions International Coworker Conference. That too was special. We have, and we're a relatively small organization, but we have 17 stations. That's not counting those in Germany, but 17 stations all over the world. So it is important for us to come together, get to know each other, because we contact each other if we know that a ship is going, say, from here to Hong Kong. We've got a station there. There was a problem maybe on one of the ships where a seafarer had a need. I can contact my colleague and say, listen, watch out for so-and-so. He needs special care. Or he needs something. Antwerp is a beautiful city. There on your right, you see the Easter Bunny or the Duracell Bunny. Just to the left of that is the Antwerp Harbor Hotel. That's a seafarer mission station. It's an ecumenical station like Durban. But they call it a hotel because they've got, I think, 64 rooms where seafarers can stay, but also other guests. So if you travel, want to travel, cheap but good accommodation, I've got a few contacts for you. I won't take commission, I promise. Where you can stay in Antwerp, in Hamburg, in Hong Kong, all over the world. We've got places where people can stay. But in Antwerp, we obviously spent a lot of time with each other. And the bottom right, that was when we were in a restaurant. On the very right-hand side, the man with the bald head, that's my boss, our Secretary General, Matthias Ristau. Part of us, and we're a good team. It's wonderful working together. The Duracell Bunny, well, that looks like a Duracell Bunny. If in Antwerp, you have to go to the chocolate factory. Now, that's made of chocolate, that bunny. Now, there were many other pictures that I took of statues or figures that were made from chocolate. We've even got, they even have Adam and Eve complete with the leaves in chocolate there. Absolutely amazing. The chocolate is wonderful. Slightly different to the Nestle that we know. And that, of course, is the main cathedral in the center, the top left-hand corner in Antwerp. That was in April. And then after that, I went for a week over to England, but that was private, to visit my son and daughter-in-law who live there now. And then in June, I flew over to Hamburg. That's the next one. Left bottom corner, that's one of those hotels that I was talking about in Hamburg, Seafarer Hotel, where I stayed. And we had a good AGM. And the wonderful news is that the Deutsche Seemannsmission, we were battling financially even before COVID already, and we were starting to close stations. That's why we're down to 17 international stations because of finances. But somehow the German government has come on board and is giving us good money, and we're looking at opening new stations. That's how well we are doing. And if we get no more funding for the Deutsche Seemannsmission, we've got enough funds to last us till 2028. Amazing if somebody can say that about their financial situation. So we can look forward to some good years. Obviously, fundraising is done in the meantime. More talks are happening with the government and the German church so that we can go beyond that and open even more stations. In Hamburg, when I was at the AGM, I took the opportunity of visiting the Seafarer. They call it the Seafarer Lounge, which is a passenger terminal. Very, very busy in Hamburg. And those ships that come in Hamburg, come into port, will never be able to come into Durban. Our port is just not deep enough. So those ships are huge. But I spent some time there. You can see me standing to the left of that tower. That was that main cathedral. It's an evangelical Lutheran cathedral, believe it or not. I could see from the window of the room where I stayed. But to the right of that cathedral, me standing there with two Filipino ladies who are seafarers on one of these passenger ships. And that's to the right of that, just what it looks like when the passengers arrive. And the bottom right is just a picture overlooking the port. That was my international travels for the year. And I want to now take you back to South Africa. And our next picture is very special. Next slide is very special to me. With COVID, we had to close our station and only started opening for seafarers in September, October. We tried September, nobody came. October, one or two came. November, we had, I think, 10. And then we said, we must do something special. And December being the FIFA World Cup, we used that to lure some seafarers. And for this one occasion, the New Germany Lutheran Church youth group came and just spoke to the seafarers, helped us host them. We had a fantastic evening. And it meant so much to the seafarers when they come and they meet what they say normal people. We are normal people to them. So if anybody says you're not normal, come visit me, I'll take you on one of the ships and you'll be declared normal. Because they live amongst each other for months and with each other in these steel frames we call ships. And just to come out and meet people is very, very special to them. Now take you into outside our station, the next one. We've got beautiful grounds. It's almost like an oasis in the Durban port area. And it is unbelievable if you go to the back where those photos are taken, most of them anyway. It's amazing that you think you are in the busiest, one of the busiest ports in the southern hemisphere. And there we've got this greenery, beautiful. It's amazing. It's like an oasis. And the seafarers love it. The first seafarers that came out to after COVID came into our mission, but they went right through the mission. We've got right at the entrance, we've got a chapel, and we've got it all there. But they went straight through to the back, touched the grass. And I was watching this from a distance, and I thought, what a strange kind of religion these people must have. Because they go out, and they go on their knees, and bend over, and they keep on touching the grass. They're doing this, and I thought they were praying to some nature god or something. So very cautiously, I asked the one, what's that? And he laughed. And he said, I just want to touch grass. We've been living on steel for 12 months and more in COVID time. I just needed to touch grass. And still, even if they're only on board or their contracts are 9 months, this is post-COVID, they still just love it. And we're very proud of the grounds we have. You see the seafarers having fun and just relaxing. And the next picture, our new addition, we've got a rhino. And that is also so special to the seafarers that we've got that there. Many photos are taken. The person on the right-hand side with that Father Christmas beard is not a seafarer. He was once. He's retired. His wife was treasurer of the Durban Seafarers Mission Station, a board of management, which I'm also part of. She was treasurer for many years. And her dream was to bring a rhino, obviously not a live one, that would be a bit impossible, to the station. And she passed away at the end of last year. And fortunately, this year in August, we got it with the help of the Wildlife Trust and Izimvelo, who've partnered with us now because they see us as good partners to pass on the message about those myths, the false myths about what rhinos can do to you and where they can help you and how they can help you. I won't go into detail. You might know what I mean. And to the left is our chairman's wife, also standing proudly next to our rhino. The top left and right pictures are just pictures of seafarers. That is the main job, is to go on board the vessels. Because seafarers work in shifts, and not all of them can come to the mission just because of their shifts. So we go, as chaplains, go onto the ships. And sometimes we have 2 minutes with a seafarer, sometimes 5 minutes. If we're lucky, it's 20 minutes if they invite us into the canteen for lunch. And we always then take food because it is part of the culture, especially the Filipinos. If you don't eat with them, you are saying, I don't trust you. And that message we certainly don't want to say. We want to be Saubona people to them. The next picture is also an exciting one. We had a celebration, and I was one of those that was invited to it. Of the Mercy Ships. This is an organization that started in the USA. They had their 40th birthday celebration on one of their ships that is now in Durban, the African Mercy. This was in July. And this is a hospital ship, the African Mercy. They've got everything on the ship, x-rays, scanning machines, operating theaters, everything. So they travel along the African coast and are in the ship, the hospital for those nations. They do wonderful work. Most of the seafarers on the Mercy ships are volunteers. In fact, it costs them to be on a ship because of all the tickets that have to be bought. The only thing they get for free is once they're on board, free board and lodging. It was a wonderful occasion. They even had a live band there. And the Filipinos especially love singing. And they really joined in with that music. It was special. The next picture, those are the sad moments that we have. This happened last month. We got a message that one of the seafarers passed away. He died of malaria. And I didn't take pictures while we were doing the service, only when that top left-hand picture, you can see the body being lowered with a crane. Now, we were at the ship at about 9 o'clock that evening because we were told that's when it is there. And we wanted, it was a colleague of mine, a Catholic priest and myself that went. And we went there to say, we want to be when the ship arrives. But everything with port health, police clearance, customs, we eventually got into onto the ship at about 1:30 that morning. But we were standing down there, and as the seafarers on the ship came down, they weren't allowed off. We weren't allowed on. because of all the officials and everything happening. But they saw us, and we were clearly dressed as chaplains. They knew they were seen. And that is with no words, just the church is here. God is here. Now, for the seafarers who lose a colleague on board ship, it's quite traumatic because they live together for so long. They become friends of all the different nations that work together on one ship. They become friends and they become close to each other. The Filipinos, 80% of them are Roman Catholic, so that's why it was important also to take a Catholic priest along. But just think about this for a moment. What happens if someone passes away on a ship and they're out there at sea? What happens to that body? Now, if they're fortunate, they'll have a refrigerated container that is empty on the ship. Then it can be used for the body. But if not, it goes into the same cool room where the food is kept. Just think about that. It's not always easy. Our next picture, and I'm coming almost to the end of my pictures. We're nearing Christmas time. The top left hand, you see beanies, handmade beanies. And below that, Tante Sieglinde, I don't know who knows her, turned 95 this year. Last year, she knitted just over 100 beanies for us. She's almost blind, but she says, my hands can still move, so she keeps on knitting. That is Saubana ministry in action, in the true sense of the word. She will never, ever meet a seafarer who's going to get one of those beanies. But a seafarer that receives a hand-knitted beanie knows there's a person behind it, a person who took time for him or for her. I am seen. I'm not just a number. The bottom right-hand corner, some German biscuits. We buy a lot of biscuits when we have functions, and the seafarers love them, and they love also these toppers and those kinds of biscuits. But these German ones also are Saubana ministry to them. They're special because they know somebody baked this for me, stood in their kitchen, baked it for me. They absolutely appreciate them. So without sounding like a beggar, I want to ask you to knit beanies and bake Christmas biscuits for Christmas. I'll come and fetch, I promise you. It means so much to them. And just the top right-hand corner is the logo of the German Seafarers Mission, the Deutsche Seemannsmission. Now, some of you have heard this. It was in my previous presentation. I spoke about that quite a lot, so I will just summarize. That is supposed to be a cross on a wave. That's what it was originally, on a flag. That's what it was originally designed to be. But the seafarers call us people of the smiley cross. Wow. What a privilege to be part of an organization that is called People of the Smiley Cross, because that is our God. That is the God who says, Saubana, to you and me. Who says, I see you in your situation. The God that smiles over you and me because he loves us. Incredible. Let's go to the next slide, the Saubana ministry. And the first point that we are told that Jesus said, and it came out clearly in our gospel reading, but also in our watchword, the most important part of the Saubana ministry is to love God. Now, dear congregation, I know if I was sitting with you and somebody stood here and asked the question, do you love God? We'll all put up our hand. Yes, we do. We do. But what was your day look like to this afternoon? Weather's not so good for a braai, lunch braai, but let's imagine you're having a lunch braai with all your friends, a couple of drinks. Do you love God? Or tomorrow when you're at work and you have all your laborers that start giving you trouble and the ones that didn't pitch or the ones that pitch half drunk. Do you love God? Then it's not so easy to answer this question. But it is the most important to love God. The amazing thing is that the God who loves me, who sees me, doesn't make my love to him conditional for his love. That's amazing. He loves me in spite of, always. And he will always smile over me. But do I really love God? When I meet people, what do they see? When I'm driving, and this is personal to me, those taxis, oof. You know that you don't have to use bad language, but it comes, eh? Do I love God? And when you hit those potholes that we've paid taxes for to fix, I've had to buy 4 sets of new tires this year alone. That's just in the import area. Do I love God? I want you to go to the next one. I saw this on one of my trips, this picture. We do not have Wi-Fi. Talk to each other. Pretend it's 1995. Ay, 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 ay. We love our cell phones and they're very good and they're helpful. But if you go into restaurants and people sit on their phones and they don't talk to each other anymore, it's sad. When we get a phone call or get a message, we quickly take out our phones. Are we that quick to respond to God? And the last slide. So part of the Salbana ministry is to love God. That's the most important. And the other two are, and to love your neighbor as yourself. Now, if you look closely, the word neighbor. Jesus never said, love your neighbors. He said, love your neighbor. And that's important, that difference. You know, who's my neighbor? That's the question we often ask. And is it the person living next to me? Who is my neighbor? Are we neighbors to each other here? It's so easy to say, yes, we should be. But Jesus said, love your neighbor. That's the person who's sitting right next to you now, to your left, to your right. Maybe you've got two, depending on where you're sitting. That's your neighbor now. And that's the person you must love now. And when you get to your farm, for those who farmers, tomorrow morning and that first drunk laborer that arrives with his babalas, that's your neighbor. Fortunately, the taxis drive past so they don't stay in my labor long enough. The person I come into contact with is my neighbor. And that's the person I'm to love. And it goes on as yourself. Now, dear congregation, do you love yourself? Now, I'm sure every one of us has certain things about us that we don't like. And that's okay. Because education, discipline, life affects our person. And some of it we've learned that is not so good. We don't have to like the not so good. But do I love myself? Do I love the person that God created? Warts and all. Because if I can't love myself, I cannot love my neighbor. Maybe, and I'm not saying Salbana ministry doesn't start with God. He's the most important. But the second level of neighbor and yourself, I should be and do a bit of Salbana ministry to myself every now and again. When I get up in the morning and I wash my face and I look at that mirror, that I can smile and say, Salbana, I see you. We love ourselves. And this not in the negative sense, in putting myself before everybody else, but it is, if I love myself, I can love my neighbor. And then I can do to my neighbor what I would like to be done to me. And I could speak the words that to someone that I would like somebody to also sometimes say to me. Jesus challenges us to put the Salbana ministry into action. And it's a tough one. And we will fail every now and again. If you're a bit like me, maybe more often than not. But he keeps on smiling. He keeps on saying Salbana. And he keeps on saying, I love you. And every time he says, I see you, he says, let's try again. That's our God. And he wants us to be his hands, feet, ears, eyes, voices in this world for him. It's easy to say, yes, I accept that challenge, sitting here in this context. Tomorrow back at work. Do you accept the challenge? Let's be quiet and pray. Dear God, you're such an amazing God. And we can't even put into words how good you are to us, how incredibly huge your love is for us. And you see us. Thank you for that privilege. Help us to see ourselves. Help us to see our neighbor. Help us to put into action the love that you give us. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and may the love of God, and may the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all. Amen.
Changes everything.
Let us pray. Dear God, we thank you that we can be here, that we have a safe environment to just celebrate and worship your name. We thank you for everyone who's made this possible, for the many donations given, for the tithes that are paid. We pray that you may bless every hand that gives, so that we can have this wonderful space. Father, we thank you that we may know, wherever we are, whatever we do, you see us, because you love us. Help us to pass that on to others. God, we also pray that you may be with those people that are fighting with each other, places in this world where there's no peace. We pray for your mighty hand of love to come into the hearts of people, that they may find each other, and that peace may come and happen. We think of this also for our country, and we have so many tensions, so many problems. We pray, shine your light, your love over all our people. Let South Africa be the land that we all dream of. We pray for our leaders, that you may give them a change of heart if they have bad intentions. Let them focus on what is good for everyone and not just on themselves. Father, we pray for your church, that your church may be bold in this world, that your church may proclaim the truth, and that your church may proclaim, most of all, your grace through Jesus Christ. Help us be part of the church that is bold and ready to proclaim. Help us to be that in our daily lives as we put into practice the Salbona ministry. We thank you that as we do so, we will not be alone. You will walk with us. And God, in closing, we think of those people that are close to us, people that are hurting, people that have lost a loved one, people that are angry. We pray, as we think of those people, you know their names because we're thinking of them now, God, we pray that a miracle may happen in their lives. All our prayers we bring to you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Dear congregation, in a moment we will be celebrating Holy Communion. We'll be celebrating a feast with our smiley God. And we want to celebrate with him as he keeps on smiling and says, I forgive you. And as he keeps on saying, let's try again, I want to strengthen your faith. And in preparation for Holy Communion, let us sing the song, Good, Good Father.
unexplainable I can hardly think as you call me, deeper still as you call me, deeper still as you call me, deeper still. Good, good Father, to you are, to you are, to you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. You're a good, good
Father, you are good, good Father. Thank you for your compassion. Thank you for your readiness to forgive. And we pray that you will help us look into ourselves now. Just take time to bring that. Father, you've heard those words we said in our minds or just thought of. We pray, have mercy on us. And we now want to bring everything that we may not even have thought of also to you.
And we do so with the words, Jesus, that you taught us. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he gave thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, He took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to them and said, "All of you drink of it. This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And the peace of the Lord be with us all. Amen. You're all invited to partake. I think you know the practice better than I do. If I start explaining to you, I'm probably going to confuse you. I'll ask two people to help with the distribution. I will rather step back because of my flu. While you're coming up, I'm going to read what Pastor Udo said. We are using the chalice again in the tray with little glasses. On one side of the glasses will contain wine, the other juice. The wine is darker than the juice. If you would like a glass, then please take one. If you want to use the chalice, then please reach for that instead. While we do the first round, I invite all those with pre-packed elements to celebrate it with us. You can do that seated or standing as you prefer. Please lift your clear plastic above the wafer and take the wafer into your hand. Are there any? Okay, then we can continue. May the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in true faith unto everlasting life. Go in the peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. body of Christ given for you. Amen. We come back. Amen. May we too go in the peace of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. May the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in true faith unto everlasting life. Go in the peace of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us pray. Dear God, thank you for this very special moment. We heard of your love, and now in Holy Communion we were able to taste, see, and feel that love in us. Help us remember this moment as we go out into this week to deal with the challenges of this week, that we're going strengthened and with you in us. We pray that we will be able to love as you first loved us. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. The blessing after the next song. Before. Okay. Sorry. And now receive God's blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine over you and be with you. The Lord be with you in his presence through the Holy Spirit. God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit bless you now and forevermore. Amen.
Glory taught the stars to shine.
wish you all a blessed Sunday. I'm not going to greet you at the door because I'm a hugger. And I'm not allowed to, so I'll resist the temptation and stand here. But you all hugged. God bless you.